into his house, interrupts his party, and approaches his mistake. Now, Luke doesn't tell us what specific sins he was known for. Most scholars say he was probably known for sexual sin, most likely, or probably too. We don't know for sure. But here's what we do know. We know that he's described as a sinner. And not just a sinner like we tend to think of the phrase, meaning somebody who commits a sin. That's true of everybody. This was a very specific term that was used to describe people who were well known for an openly sinful lifestyle. And the Pharisees believed that being holy meant staying completely separated from people like her. And that's why Simon responds the way he does in verse 39 when this woman comes in and washes Jesus' feet. Look at how Simon responds in verse 39. It says, now when the Pharisee who had invited him saw this, he said to himself, if this man were a prophet, he would have known who and what sort of woman this is who's touching him, for he is a sinner. Now, do you hear what he's saying? Because the core of it is, if Jesus knew about her sin, then he would reject her. If Jesus knew about her sin, then he would reject her. He doesn't seem to be aware yet that Jesus came for sin. And that's the kind of culture that we can create if we're not careful.